drones are clearly one factor in a much more complex mix of circumstances that have created the situation in Yemen. My name is Stefan Wolf. I'm a professor of international security and an affiliate of the Institute for Conflict Cooperation and Security. My main research focuses on the management of civil wars and the rebuilding of war-torn societies all over the world. In the ESRC project on the political effects of UAVs, we were concerned with two main questions. One was the effect of drones on the relationships between states. And the other aspect, which is the one that is more closely related to my own research, is the effect that the use of drones has on domestic peace processes, which obviously are of significant concern in the three countries that we researched, namely Afghanistan, Pakistan, and Yemen. Specifically in Yemen, the use of drones is primarily for counter-terrorist purposes. The use of drones in Yemen has a very long history. The first strike, first targeted killing by drone occurred in Yemen in 2002. And then since 2008, we have seen a significant increase in the number of strikes, but also a significant increase in the use of drones for intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance purposes, all primarily driven by a US counter-terrorist agenda, rather than by an agenda that would seek primarily the resolution of Yemen's internal conflicts and the stabilization of the country. Here, drones are clearly one factor, but they are just one factor in a much more complex mix of circumstances that have created the situation in Yemen, where the country has gone from one of the few hopeful cases of the Arab Spring, with a clear prospect of a negotiated transition from a dictatorship to a democracy, to a country that is now not just teetering on the brink of civil war, but that has experienced a very severe civil war, high levels of external intervention, an increasing number of casualties as a result of that, none of which are directly related to the use of drones. So in that sense, Yemen is perhaps not the classic case to demonstrate a causal relationship between drones and particular outcomes that we can observe more generally. But it is important to bear in mind that drones are clearly part of a mix of factors that have created the situation that we face in Yemen today.